What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to show you how to mine ALEPHIUM on an FPGA, more specifically the E300, which does consist of three VU35P FPGAs within it. Now, it also sounds like the public bitstreams from Whitefire also emerge for the FK33s. I do not have any of those, so I cannot show you how to do that. I do have a C1100 here, but that bitstream is not yet available. It is coming soon, and a lot more bitstreams for the rest of the FPGAs should be available within the next few weeks. Hopefully. We'll stay tuned and keep you up to date. All right, so if you just bought a brand new FPGA or something, I do have discount links down in the description for the Osprey E300s, if that's something you're looking at, or maybe you picked up some FK33 somewhere on eBay or something, and you're getting your wallet for the first time, head on over to the ALEPHIUM website and just simply click on Get the Wallet. Once you're there, they have a various amount of wallets here. You got a desktop wallet, extension wallet, or a mobile wallet. Just set it up with your seed phrase and passwords, everything you got to do, and then get your wallet address. That way you have something to mine to. All right, so on the E300, we're just going to run through a couple things. First, you got to make sure you're on the proper firmware here. So we're going to go to update firmware, and you got to make sure you say N2.0.25. This is what did add the ALEPHIUM bitstream into these FPGAs here. If you don't have it, you can either download manually or simply set this to auto update and hit save, and within 5 minutes it will auto update to the latest version, which will be N2.0.25. I usually manually update it because then you can get them a little bit early than waiting for the auto update, but you do got to keep track of Osprey's updates in their Discord to get those files, so make sure you do that. Second, we're going to come into here, and in order to set your voltages and stuff, so this is your core voltages on your chips, this is your memory voltage for a majority of these coins. We're not really using memory, even for ALEPHIUM. You can just keep this down to 1000 or whatever the lowest here we can see. The HBM memory is 1000 to 1300. Just set it to 1000, that'll put it around this range here. I'm just going to run some nice efficient settings here. When I run this, I'm just going to be running a voltage of 600, and then here you can see your board temp, FPGA temps, and voltage regulator module temps. This is like your board that does deliver the voltages to your chips. You want to make sure that this does remain under 90 degrees when you do start cranking this up in clock speeds and voltages. But you know what? It does seem to run ALEPHIUM pretty efficiently and doesn't really seem to get that warm. Again, if you live in a desert, that might be a totally different situation. Now, next step to actually set this up is go into the miner. So here you can see up front, the very first one right under developer, this is the different developers, Team Red Miner, Allfather, K1 Lab, Whitefire. Whitefire is the bitstream dev you are going to want to use for ALEPHIUM. Each one has its own Team Red Miner. That's with Kaspa and other coins. Or you can simply go down to Algo here and select the coin you want. Here you can see Ironfish. It'll use Team Red Miner. If we go to ETC, it's Team Red Miner again. If we go to ALEPHIUM, it'll automatically go to Whitefire. So you can just choose the Algo, which in this case is saying the coin, not really the Algo Blake 3. But just choose the coin you want here, and it'll bring up the proper developer and so on. So now we're going to change our pool parameters, wallet, and everything we need. So worker ID, obviously we can see right here is Rabid E300. That's pretty self-explanatory. The wallet, this is where you're going to copy your wallet address for ALEPHIUM. And pool, this is what you're going to want to change. Now, this does not save or default to any pools by default. If I was mining Radiant, everything in here would still be all my Radiant settings, Radiant wallet address, and Radiant name if I had it named something else for Radiant. So every time you change it, you are going to have to redo your wallet and everything because it doesn't save the parameters for each algorithm or coin that you're mining. It does sound like that might be a thing in a future update, but right now it'll always keep the old settings no matter what coin you were mining. All right, so now we're gonna have to enter their pool. This is the location where you do wanna collaboratively put your hash together with a bunch of other miners and mine together to hit blocks and then get rewards. It makes things easier when you're pool mining. So in this case, we're gonna be utilizing Hero Miners, which does look like they finally tweaked for the FPGAs, and now FPGAs can mine to the Hero Miners pool as well. So I'm gonna go with North America, US West here. So I'm just gonna copy this, right click, copy, go back into the Osprey here. I do believe you do have to have Stratum plus TCP, so make sure that is in there or you may get an error. I might try it with both just to see to make sure, but once I get that in, we're all done. Next up, this is to set your FPGA core clocks. Now, if you're unfamiliar, how it's going to perform in hash rates, 620 on the core and then 600 millivolts, that is about your 13 to 14 gigahash and running as most efficient as you possibly can. If you have cheap power, you can crank this up. I do have a hash rate video on the E300 for ALEPHIUM, so be sure to check that out if you're looking for different types of settings here. Here I am going to run with 620, pretty simple process. All you got to do is type in 620 here and that will set your core clock. Now with this, you can see all FPGAs will use the same clock when mining Radiant, Etika, or ALEPHIUM. This means setting the 620 here will set the 620 on all three FPGAs, where some coins you do put it based on FPGA 0, 1, and 2, setting them each one individually. This one setting is for all three. So once you get all the settings and pool parameters in, all you got to simply do is hit that start button. This will start loading the bit streams and start mining to the pool of your choice. In this case, Hero Miners, which is the sponsor of today's video. So while you're waiting for these bit streams and everything to load, you can actually click on the miner logs here and you can see everything that's going on within the miner, how, what the percentage is, what you're running at, you know, your rejected shares versus accepted shares and so on. Once everything does begin mining, right now you can see it's just starting the ALEPHIUM service and now it is beginning to load the bitstream. So I'm just going to let it sit here so you guys can watch it do its thing and then we'll kind of come back once it's fully loaded and begins mining. And we can see we have successfully clocked all our FPGAs up. We are now beginning to mine and we got an accepted share. So everything is looking as intended. All right, so coming into the mining pool itself, I can see that we are detected. Simply put your wallet address in here and we can see we are sent a share less than a minute ago. And here's our current estimated rewards. Obviously, we're only at 106 megahash. Over time, as we send more shares, it'll get up to that 13, 14 gigahash based on my settings, but the pool is working as intended. Everything is looking good. And right here, it does say we have reduced the block unlock time from 500 minutes to 5 minutes in order to pay the miners faster. Miners will receive funds to the wallet 100 times faster. So that's pretty sweet, I guess. If you do want, you know, instant gratification on blocks and everything you do find, you will get your rewards about 100x faster than traditional way of waiting for those blocks to unlock. All right, guys, so thank you for checking out this video. Hopefully it did help you to get up and running on your E300s if you do have them. And if you don't have one and looking for them, I will have them discount codes down in the description. Be sure to use them. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.